How's it going, everybody? Having posted a record-breaking run in 2012, becoming the first player in pro football history to record three straight 3,000 all-purpose yard seasons, Oahu's own Chad Owens was named the Canadian Football League's most outstanding player tonight. Toronto Argonaut receiver and return man claimed the CFL's highest individual honor with his son, Chad Jr., by his side at the league's awards banquet in Toronto Thursday. Three-time All-Star broke the CFL single-season total yards mark with 3,863, including a league's best 1,328 receiving yards with six scores. Now, Owens received 41 of 57 first-place votes for the award. 30-year-old Roosevelt graduate and former UH All-American will next go after a league title as his Argos will face off with Calgary on Sunday night in the 100th annual Grey Cup. Kickoff from Toronto is set for 1 in the afternoon Hawaii time, and it will be televised on the NBC Sports Network.
I'm Dominic Arella of the Detroit Lions. This is my wife Yvonne, Taylor, Dylan, and Dayton. On behalf of my family and the Detroit Lions,
Happy Thanksgiving.
In a Thanksgiving tradition, Detroit played host to one of three games in the NFL today, where St. Louis graduate 12th-year center Dominic Raiola and his Lions suffered a heartbreaking loss in overtime to the 10-1 Texans. Now, Detroit led 31-24 in the fourth quarter as number 51 helped pave the way on 525 yards of offense. Houston, though, rallied back to force an extra frame, and in OT, kicker Shane Graham drove the 32-yard game winner, 34-31 the final. Lions now fall to 4-7. Over in the Garden State, 8-3 Patriots put a beat down on the 4-7 Jets, while New York quarterback Mark Sanchez even got beat down by his O-line's backside. One of the Jets' five turnovers came when Sanchez got sassed by Brandon Moore's Mooley. New England wins 49-19. Now, prior to kickoff, New England cut former Warrior Greg Salas. For more details on the transaction, check out KHON2.com. Over in the Lone Star State, Washington's rookie quarterback Robert Griffin III led the Redskins to a win over the Cowboys. Reigning Heisman Trophy winner threw for 311 yards with four touchdowns, 38-31 the final. Both teams now move to 5-6 on the year. And tomorrow night in Halawa, 14th annual First Hawaiian Bank HHSAA State Championship Games will take place, where in Division I, defending champ Kahuku will go after its seventh state tourney title, facing off with 2008 winner Punahou for a second straight season. Now over in Division II, Maui champion Lahaina Luna will look to dethrone the Kings and five-time defending champion Iulani. Our Sam Spangler caught up with Raider royalty in this week's edition of the 76 Premium Profile.
After winning the last five state crowns, the Iolani Red Raiders have become the Dukes of Division II.
They understand that there's been a standard of excellence set for them, and it's their job to take it to the next level.
Men in Black are counting on quarterback Reese Foy to retain the throne. Number five has racked up 2,311 yards and 30 touchdowns in his senior campaign.
Our goal has been to win the state championship, and you know, we kept that goal in mind as seniors. We tried to lead the younger classmen.
He'll tell you it starts with the offensive line, which is somewhat true. But, you know, everything centers around him. We've been spoiled with him.
If there's a team built to challenge the Raiders dynasty, it's the Lunas out of Lahaina. Boys from the west side packed a big, physical defense to Oahu that rivals some of the top defensive fronts in Division I. Lunas allow 3.7 points per game and have pitched seven shutouts.
After that Radford game, that there was no celebration, you know, there was no hoopla on the sideline, because they know that the job wasn't done yet, and this is the week that they wanted to get to, and they know that they need to finish the job, and they know that they have a tough opponent in Lahaina Luna. And, you know, they know what needs to get done.
Title bout is set for 4 o'clock, Hawaiian Airlines Field at Aloha Stadium. Sam Spengler, KHON2 Sports.
Thanks a lot, Sam, for the report. And tomorrow, the stadium, it is going to be rocking. Rocking. It's going to be wild.
Sounds like it. And there was apparently a great send-off for the kids from Lahaina Luna.
Oh, absolutely. And the Valley Isle, they support those kids, man. Big time.
Big party of night. Send them off with a police and fire truck escort. We'll post some pictures on Facebook there for you.